Welcome to the Networking with Michelle podcast, the show dedicated on providing you the how-tos of marketing and networking strategies. Here we believe in the Jim Rohn quote, success is nothing more than a few simple disciplines practiced every day. Wow. Can you believe it's been 2 years? Hey, everyone. Welcome to the Networking with Michelle podcast. I'm your host, Michelle Gomez, and this is a 2-year anniversary. I wish I could break out in song a little Tony, but you know, I'm going to hold on. I'm going to hold off on that. Okay. No, but seriously, it's been 2 years. I remember it was, I believe, April 8th, somewhere around there, 2015. I was trying to launch my podcast before heading to New Media Expo, but I had some snags with iTunes or whatever. I went to the conference and I spoke to the company Libsyn. They help you, you know, they're a podcast hosting company. So kind of like you have GoDaddy for web hosting, Libsyn's podcast hosting. So I upload my episodes there and they distribute it to iTunes, Google Play, and all these other platforms. And I told them my problem. I went somewhere, came back 30 minutes later, problem solved. I was up and running 2 years. And this podcast journey has been a real treat. It's been a real experience. It's taught a lot about me, by myself, on the business side, discipline for one. I've always tried to be a blogger. I always tried to write on previous websites, my website, and just very inconsistent. And podcast somehow has disciplined me. And I don't know if it's just looking at the numbers, tangible numbers, actually hearing feedback. And of course, this is, you know, I was trying to blog, you know, pre-influencer, pre-follower and all this kind of, you know, social media and everything. And I'll definitely say doing the interviews holds you accountable. You know, I have someone on the other end that's hopefully looking forward to be interviewed by me. And so podcasting has definitely disciplined me. Another thing I always say, what I love about podcasting is when I was an author, I had a book, or I'm an author, but when I wrote Network Navigate, that book allowed me to invite myself or request to be on someone else's platform. But by me having a podcast, I'm able to invite people on my platform. But hey, I'm interested in you. Hey, can I interview you? Can you come on? And I've been very fortunate, very, very fortunate with some of the guests that I've had over the past 2 years, from Lamar and Ronnie Tyler, George Frazier, Paul Brunson. I'm going to talk about him a little more in a few minutes. Christine St. Bill, she's definitely shown me some love over the years. Isom Quaid from PancakesAndCider.com. Just a lot of good people. I'm so grateful and humbled on this journey of podcasting. And I'm going to tell you something. Right now, it is Monday night, April 10th. I have some things lined up. I'm hoping that will manifest within a few days. It has me so excited. I'm feeling really fearless right now. I'm feeling really, really, really fearless right now with my podcast. And one thing, I've been promoting my podcast as a professional development, marketing, networking strategies with a bit of entrepreneurial advice. But at the end of the day, Networking with Michelle, it's all about me expanding my network and connecting with the guests that I interview. I really like to say conversations, the conversations I have with the guest. And I'm hoping that these conversations resonate so well that you feel comfortable reaching out to them as well. And I don't think I preach that enough. I've had a few people say they've reached out or started following certain guests on Twitter because, you know, they were on the show, and that's what it's about. And I've struggled, especially that first year. I wasn't as consistent. Podcasting is a lot of work, though. Ooh, it's a lot of work, and it's an extra expense. But I promise you this. Every time I interviewed someone, it was the perfect time. It's like when you go to church on Sunday and the pastor's preaching that word, like, you know, that message is just for you. And that's how I feel a lot of time with those interviews. Like, man, that nugget, you know, that tweetable, that quote, that's what I needed to hear right now. Not 2 weeks ago when we had to cancel and reschedule, but what they just said is what I needed to hear right now to carry me through. And there's been some pivotal interviews that have really not just confirmed my thought process, because I've been doing a lot on mindset lately, but some of these interviews have just really transformed, you know, not just my outlook, but on how I deal with people. I think I've been a little bit more patient. Every time I have a conversation with someone, it gives me a little bit more perspective on how the world, on how the human race works, right? And I'm just grateful for all of my guests. And I just want to let you know, even though I'm the host, even though I'm behind the mic, I'm here to learn too. Like, as much as I know, I don't know. And I have learned a lot by managing this podcast, the conversations I've had, the conversations I've had with you, the listener, the feedback. I love doing the surveys. Some of y'all actually have relationships with, like, we jump on the phone, we jump on Skype, and we shoot the breeze for 45 minutes for 2 hours. Now, I don't have a lot of time, but I'm definitely willing to do that, you know? And I love podcasting. I love it. I love it. So this is really an update episode. I just feel like I need to catch up with y'all, and what better way than on the anniversary day. So it's April, 4 months into the year, feeling really good. It's a beautiful thing when you're in a good place, and I feel like I'm in a good place. I'm just so grateful because I'm able, right? And I don't have a lot of money, but it's not bad either, right? I'm paying my bills. I'm hanging out with friends. I work my butt off. Business is good. I'm just grateful because I'm able. And right now, it's enough, you know, I'm working towards more, but it's enough. So some of the things that have happened this year, let's see. So Paul Brunson. All right. Paul Brunson, I was fortunate to interview him in, I think, September, October 2015. I did a 4-part series called Networking Dating, and he was the fourth person I interviewed, and he came in, brought the male perspective to this whole thing. So if you don't follow Paul Brunson, he is an entrepreneur, mentor, former matchmaker. He sold his business last year, his matchmaking business, and he's all about entrepreneurship and being an expert when it comes to micro business. And boy, this man knows his stuff. He was fortunate to work with Oprah and another billionaire, and he is just a wealth of knowledge when it comes to business. And I remember I did that interview. As always, anytime someone says yes to me, I'm surprised. And we knocked out that interview. And I remember the top of 2016, I was like, man, for some reason, I would like for him to mentor me or do a consultation. And I really didn't know what that looked like, because he's very generous with this content. And he does these great 1-minute videos, like offering advice and all this kind of stuff. And I wanted mentorship, but I didn't know what that looked like with him, right? There's a cost. What do I really need to get and all this kind of stuff? And I just assumed I didn't have the money. I didn't even bother it. I didn't bother him. I didn't email him or nothing. It's like, whatever. And I remember he did this video. This was like the beginning of 2016. He did this video and he's like, I just got off a mentor call. And you know, my mentee asked me, how do I get more followers? You know, like something crazy. And I was like, guess I won't be asking. I won't be asking for mentorship about that, right? Because definitely struggling with that, trying to build this audience and it's the followers validate you or whatever. So after he did that video, I was like, okay, let's go back to the drawing board. And we never drew anything again. So this year, fast forward, this year, 2017, he did a video and he was like, I'm opening up a mentoring program. And I remember, oh my God, like I had just got in the car. I was heading to work, to class. And I was like, I read it because I was at the light or something. I read it and I was just so excited. Like I couldn't wait to get to school just so I can apply. Like that's how excited I was. And I was like, hold on, class, give me 15 minutes and we'll start something. But right now I'm about to do this application. And I did the application and I got accepted. I got accepted in February. So Paul Brunson has put together a mentoring program. It's 20 weeks. And basically we started first or second week of March, and we're running all the way into July, if I'm not mistaken, June or July. And there is a cost to it, but hey, you know what? The investment's $1,200, right? And at the time, this is a testament. At the time, I had the money, right? I'm doing the payment plan. I had the money. I was like, I can wing this from my paycheck or whatever. You know, not even a big deal. Like I didn't even hesitate when it came to this. And I promise you, as soon as I got accepted to the program, I got two new clients. Money flows. All right. So I just wanted to say that. It's just a testament. Sometimes you got to step out on faith, but lots of times we just have to make a decision. And that's when the positivity is going to flow. I'm going to keep preaching later, though. Just hold on. But yeah, so it's a mentoring program, 20 weeks. He has multiple multiple groups, right? He has a branding group, a startup group, and I think another group if you're trying to sell your business. I'm in the thought leadership group. I'm all about thought leadership, how I can influence, impact the audience with my message. And let me tell you something. This brother is delivering. I was the first person in the hot seat. There's 10 in a group. We have our accountability partners. I was the first person in the hot seat. And his contact marketing perspective, strategy, whatever you want to call it, is totally different than anything that I have heard or seen. Obviously, I listen to a lot of podcasts. I read magazines and books all about thought leadership and stuff like this. And I feel like in this MBA programming, I feel like in this mentoring program, I feel like it is content marketing meets MBA program. I did one semester of MBA program. I had to drop out because, you know, it was crazy. But from the time I was there, now I definitely see the merge of the two, right? Online marketing meets MBA program. And like, that is me, high level, just the right pace. I still have a lot of work to do. And we just had 3 sessions. But oh my God, I'm telling you, absolutely blown away. Worth every penny, right? I mean, I was fortunate to be the first person on the hot seat. And like after that, I was like, I'm done. Like if I didn't attend any more sessions, I got my money's worth. Okay. So please, you know, check out my brother, Paul C. Brunson.com. Just an extraordinary man. This man is so generous with his knowledge. So check him out on Facebook, Instagram. He's always doing videos. He's a family guy. Just a great role model, period. So shout out to Brother Paul. Also, that same week I got accepted to the mentoring program, I got accepted for a board position. So I had a colleague recommend me to this board, to this organization, and did the application. Wasn't even looking for it, did the application, got accepted. So the organization is called Lyft Fund. And Lyft Fund is based in San Antonio, Texas. And it's a nonprofit organization that focuses on micro-lending to small business owners of diverse backgrounds. And the reason why I decided to move forward with this organization is because I felt like it was the best of both worlds. I have a finance background, have a bachelor's in finance, worked at Chase, Citigroup, Invesco Investment Services. I love marketing, have that degree, and I love entrepreneurship, right? I'm addicted to entrepreneurship. And I just felt like this organization allows me to put all of these skills in one pot and mix it together, as well as, this was another thing, if you remember the episode 76 with J. Kelly Hoey, one thing I learned about her was the importance of having a diverse network, right? Whether it's race, gender, industries, etc. That was one of the biggest takeaways that I got from that interview, only for this opportunity to pop up. And I promise you, this woman's voice was in my head, like, diversify your network, diversify your network. So when they accepted me, the feeling was mutual. And so now I'm serving on the board of Lyft Fund, their young professional board. And we had our first meeting not too long ago, so it's still early. It's a 2-year commitment. Have a lot of things to learn and hash out. But I'm so excited and so grateful for the opportunities of this year. Been rocking and rolling. And I'm excited about my future. I always am, but I'm really cool. I'm really just happy with life right now. Let's see. Do I want to share this with y'all? All right. So I'm really happy about life, but, one thing is, I'm really considering on pursuing a PhD program. And I've made up my mind to go through this. It's a long process. So I have to see what happens. And once again, you know, once I've made up my mind, things kind of have fallen into place with just the support, the verbal support from people. And I'm grateful for that. And I'm afraid. It's so early, but I'm still afraid. And I'm definitely one of those people that have a tendency to walk into fear, walk towards my fear. But I need to study for this GRE exam. I need to get these personal statements and all of these things together to see what happens and to see if this is something that I'll take on the fall of 2018. It's crazy right now because I have student loans. Of course, I'm working on that. But 45 is like taking away the grad plus loans. And I don't know. I don't know. I'm thinking about U of H. And I'm doing marketing or even psychology, Texas A&M. Which is an hour and a half away from me in College Station. I'll do communications there. Don't know how that's going to work out. Don't want to move. Definitely don't want to drive. So that would be interesting. And then the other option is Howard, which I would do communications. So once again, I'm always pulling from extreme opposites. You know, U of H can do that and pretty much maintain the lifestyle I have right now, right? Just drive up the street, do my thing. I don't see much changing if I was to stay within the city. A&M, some small changes, small major changes would take place. And Howard, I just have to get my whole life together before I head to D.C., if that's even an option. So that's been on my mind. So I'll go ahead and share one of my greatest fears to y'all about that. So what's next? What is next? I am currently working on 3 books, and it's not intentional, but right now I have a lot on my mind. I have a lot on my heart, and I've just been writing like crazy. And I'm not gonna lie to you, like all of my thoughts, when I jot them down, it's papers all over the place, and I'm just piecing it together. So one of the books I'm working on is called Connect with Confidence. I started working on that last year. It was almost finished. I didn't like what I was writing, so I scrapped that. Got a book cover, all kinds of things done, thinking I was ready to go. And I wasn't happy with my writing, so I put that aside. But recently, I've been inspired. So I'm hoping to get that pushed out first. And with Connect with Confidence, this is like part 2 of Network Navigate and Nurture. And what I realized over the years of talking to people from all over the world about networking is, at the end of the day, you need to be aware of your strengths and you need to play to your strengths, right? Everyone is not going to do well for happy hour. Everyone's not going to do well at a conference, right? But where will you excel when it comes to making connections, right? And I kind of want to walk you through this process of how do you connect with yourself. This is so important, right? You really have to connect with yourself before you can connect with anyone else, right? So don't force yourself in an environment, whether it's the actual place or a group of people, that's going to make you be fraud, right? In layman's terms, it's going to make you be uncomfortable. But where is that place? Where is that group that you're going to be comfortable with and you're really going to have a meaningful conversation, meaningful connection? And if it's meaningful, therefore it's going to be memorable, right? And a lot of people are saying, I don't know how, or I don't, or I can't. And I'm hoping we'll connect with confidence. It shows you not necessarily how to break through those barriers, but you know what? This is who I am. I can do this. I just need to do it in my own element. And there's people just like me that we like the same thing. We're in the same element and we can have a connection. So that's what I'm trying to convey. I'm hoping to convey that very well and written, and obviously put the messaging a little bit better for situations like this when I start doing interviews and all that kind of stuff. But Connect with Confidence, that will be coming really soon, definitely by July. The second book is called Success Undefined. And if you've been following the podcast pretty much for the past 2 years, I did start at the beginning. I think my first interview was DeMerchant or Frazier. I don't know when, but in the earlier episodes, I started asking my last question, how do you define success? How do you define success? And what I'm planning to do is putting all the quotes from the previous guest into a book. And, you know, it's going to have hopefully their picture, websites, and their success quote. And that's going to be free, a free download. And I'm hoping to have that. Actually, that will come out first, because that would be something very special for the 100th episode, which is scheduled in May-ish, right? So yeah, success undefined. Success undefined. And the last book with no deadline, if you've been following me more so on social media, especially Facebook, I've been opening up a lot more, and my theme for this year, It's called, one of them was Year Disruption. And the second one is called Remaining True to My Narrative. And some of my posts on Facebook have been somewhat vulnerable, I guess, transparent, emotional. I don't know what you want to call it. But, you know, it's my thoughts. It's my thoughts. It's what's current. It's what I've been dwelling on. And I'm releasing that. And this is how I feel. And I'm remaining true to my narrative. And it's been resonating with people, with the engagement online, as well as people, you know, sending me Facebook messages, friends calling and texting me, like, man, like, I want to do that too, but I feel guilty if I do. And it's like, don't feel guilty. Like, you deserve it. You know, you deserve to step away for a day or two. You deserve a social media detox. You deserve a technology phone detox. And I'll say this, earlier, actually, my first session with my therapist this year, look, if I don't give this woman any more money, the first thing we talked about was capacity. You know, how much are you able to hold? How much are you able to withhold? And, you know, do people have the capacity for you? Do people have the capacity of Michelle Gomez? And that's one thing I've had to understand, that everyone's not going to have the capacity of what Michelle Gomez has to say online or offline. And I'm sure enough ain't equipped for what people have to say. And I'm going to be real with you. Like, last week, I mean, I'm very busy. I have a lot of commitments and obligations with the crazy teaching schedule. And I remember last week, Wednesday, I was sitting in my car and I was like, wow, like, I haven't been on the phone with anyone this week except my mom, with each, you know, me and her calling each other for whatever reason. And then Wednesday, I got upset and I ended up calling my best friend and we talked, but like, I didn't take or initiate any phone calls. And I felt so relieved because I didn't feel like I had demands coming towards me. Like, I didn't have to make decisions for myself. I didn't have to make decisions for other people. I didn't have to hear the venting session or the negative comments. I was just free. And then I wasn't running my mouth. So I got so much work done. And I posted that and people were like, man, I was just thinking about doing this, but I don't know how. Or I was just talking to a friend about this, but, and I didn't plan it, but I'm like, even if you do, it's okay. It's okay. And I just want people to understand, like, we have to be so true to ourselves before we can even be true to anyone else. I believe we have to be happy with our own lives before I can even celebrate your small win or your big win. And those are just some of the things I believe in. that's just how I feel. But I've been writing that one. Hey, Lord knows, I don't know when that was coming out. So don't even hold that to me for 2017. But I am writing. It's probably going to be something very journal-esque that's going to reveal Michelle Gomez past and present, you know. So that's what's going on. Oh, okay. All right. So this is the last thing. I'm about to wrap up, hitting that 30-minute mark. Okay. So connect with confidence and success undefined. Look, I am looking for success stories. Okay. So if, look, three things. If you read Network, Navigate, and Nurture, and it's helped you become a better networker, and it has led to some fabulous opportunity, has led to an increase in income, let me know. If you've been listening to the podcast, Networking with Michelle, and it has led to some great opportunities, connections, maybe you follow one of the past guests, you're able to connect with them, something, right? Let me know. If you just have a success story, period, right? That you just, I don't know, like something just crazy, crazy good. You know, you were able to get a better job. You were able to start this business. If you just have a success, if you are a listener and you have a success story, I want to hear from you. Okay. I want to hear from you because I want to include your story in my book. Okay. So this is what I want you to do. All right. please. Go to the show notes. You gotta go to the show notes, okay? Click, I'm gonna have this form, connection stories. You click on that, fill out the application. I want you to provide me with a brief synopsis of your story, just to give me a feel, like, hey, your book helped me do this with my elevator pitch, and you know, I got a job because of that, or whatever. Whatever, I need a success story, okay? Or I got out of my head and I was able to go to this type of event and I worked the room and whatever, closed the deal 6 months later, okay? Just give me, hook me in. That's what I need. Fill out the application, hook me in. Now, if I like your story, if I feel like you hook me in, what I plan on doing is I'm going to reach out to you via email. I want us to schedule a phone call, Skype call, or something. That way I'm able to kind of interview you. You can walk me through that process, right? Walk me through the story. I'm going to record it. Okay. I'm going to record it. That way I'm going to be able to write it down or write to that story and put it in one of the two books. Okay. I'm looking for about 10 to 15 stories all together, but hey, the more the merrier. I just got to weed through them. Okay, so if I like your story, I'm going to contact you. Hopefully we can schedule something. I record your story, write it, put it in the book, notify you. I'll send you a free copy of the book when it comes out. Okay, well, the Connect with Confidence, that one I have to send to you. Success Undefined, that one's going to be free. But yeah, I'm going to take care of you. I take care of my people. Okay. So I'm looking for stories, connection stories. So if you have one, you're a listener, you've been rocking with me for a minute, like I want to hear your success, right? Whether it's this particular thing that I'm requesting or just in general, I want to hear your success. My brother, Brandon Jones from Woke Podcast, shout out to him. He interviewed me just last week, so that should be coming out soon. I'm going to go ahead and promote that, so be on the lookout for that. But that brother had to reschedule the interview, right? So I was just like, okay, you know, I'll work with you. But anyways, it's all good. He had an interview, and he got a new position as a director. You know, I don't know. He was already doing big things, so he just got something bigger, but now he's a director of something or whatever. So, but you know, he mentioned, he showed me love. He was like, you know, your book helped me out, and now he's a director, and like, that's the stuff I want to hear. Okay. So make sure you get that to me, please, 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 please. Please go to michellegourmet.com/. What am I going to title this page? I don't even know why I'm going to title this. Okay. 2 year anniversary. I don't know. Go to michellegourmet.com. Please click on this podcast. I don't know where I'm going to put this, but if not, email me. Okay. Email me info@michellegourmet.com, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Michelle Gourmet, chats, whatever. I want to hear your story. Okay. I really want to get your story in my new book. Connect with Confidence and Success Undefined. Look, people, I feel so comfortable with you. I can ramble all day. We're going to say this podcast sponsored by Xero, beautiful accounting software. You can sign up today, get a free trial, get 30% off. Go to michellegourmet.com/Xero. See, that page is already set up, so I know you know where to go, okay? michellegourmet.com/Xero, X-E-R-O, okay? That's for your accounting software to make sure your business finances are in order. Look, I believe in you. I love you. I believe in you. And I'm excited about your future, all right? Personal connection leads to an influential network. Thanks for networking with Michelle.